Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll be discussing one question on final accounts of manufacturing sole trader, and there we are going to understand one special adjustment where one particular person is debtor as well as creditor of business, then how it should be shown in balance sheet of business. Let us start our discussion with question. You can see on screen there is one question from the following trial balance as on 31st March 2018 of Mr. Kailash, proprietor, prepare manufacturing account, trading account, profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2018 and balance sheet as on that date. We'll be marking the question now as per the items of manufacturing account, trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. First, purchase of raw material. This should be added in cost of material consumed. So, manufacturing account debit. Sales, trading credit. Computer, it's an asset. It will be recorded in balance sheet. Opening stock of raw material. Manufacturing account debit. Cost of material consumed. Opening stock of work in progress. First item on manufacturing account debit. Opening stock of finished goods, trading debit. Capital liability, first item. Freight on raw materials, manufacturing account debit, cost of material consumed. Direct wages, that is direct labor, manufacturing account debit. Factory rent, manufacturing account debit, factory expense. Factory power and fuel, factory expense, manufacturing account debit. Factory electricity, manufacturing account debit. Machinery, asset. Drawings, less from capital, liabilities. Office salaries, profit and loss account debit. Cash at bank, asset. Selling and distribution expenses, profit and loss account debit. Bank charges, profit and loss account debit. Discount allowed, profit and loss account debit. Creditors, liability. Bad debts, profit and loss account debit. Provision for bad debts, this is old provision, profit and loss account credit. Sundry debtors, asset. Bills payable, liability. Discount received, profit and loss account credit. Sundry expenses, profit and loss account debit. We have discussed all the items of trial balance. Let us discuss now adjustments. First adjustment is of closing stock. It is simple. Closing stock as on 31st March 2018, raw material 16,000. One effect, manufacturing account debit. Second effect, asset. Closing stock of work in progress 10,000. Manufacturing account credit. Second effect, asset. Closing stock of finished goods, trading credit, second effect, asset. Adjustment number 2, outstanding factory rent 1000. This will be recorded as liability, outstanding expense. Second effect, manufacturing account debit. We'll need to add this amount to the factory rent actually paid. Adjustment number 3, depreciation on machinery 5%. So depreciation will be recorded in manufacturing account debit side as a factory expense, one effect. Second effect, on asset side we have to deduct this amount. Depreciation on computers 20%, one effect, profit and loss account debit. Second effect, on asset side we have to deduct this amount from computer. Adjustment number 4, this is the most important adjustment of this question. Debtors include 15,000 due from Amir. An amount of rupees 8,000 is also due to him, which is included in creditors, which needs to be adjusted. That means this person, Mr. Amir, is our debtor as well as his creditor. He is our debtor for rupees 15,000 and he is our creditor for rupees 8,000. That means we have purchased goods from Amir on credit basis as well as we have sold goods to Amir on credit basis. Now some amount is to be received from him, some amount is to be paid to him. In that case, usual accounting procedure is of set off. That means he is not required to pay the amount which is common. That means we are required to pay him. For that purpose, what we are required to do, this 15,000 is amount receivable from him and 8,000 we are required to pay to him. So that 8,000 we are going to deduct from creditors as well as we are going to deduct that 8,000 from debtors. This adjustment is called as adjustment of set off of debtor and creditor. So one effect on asset side, less from debtors 8,000. Another effect liability side, less from creditors 8,000. Last adjustment, provide reserve for doubtful debts 10% on debtors, new RDD. One effect, it will have profit and loss account debit. Second effect, in balance sheet, we have to deduct this from the amount of debtors. With this, we have discussed all adjustments as well as trial balance items. Let us start with solving the sum. The first item is purchase of raw material 3,15,000. This will be recorded in manufacturing account on debit side under the heading raw material consumed purchases 3,15,000. Next item is sales 5 lakhs. This will be recorded in trading account on credit side. Buy sales 5 lakhs. Next item is computer 32,000. This is an asset. This will be recorded in balance sheet. Next, opening stock of raw material amount is 32,000. This will be recorded in manufacturing account debit side under the heading raw material consumed. Next, opening stock of work in progress amount is 6,000. Manufacturing account debit side, first item, opening stock of work in progress 6,000. Opening stock of finished goods 20,000. This will be recorded in trading account debit side, first item, trading account opening stock of finished goods amount is 20,000. Next item is capital of proprietor 1,05,000. This will be recorded in balance sheet on liability side as first item. Balance sheet capital on liability side 1,05,000. Freight on raw material 3,000. This is expense related to materials. Manufacturing account debit under the heading raw material consumed. Freight 3,000. Direct wages 24,000. Manufacturing account debit, direct labor or direct wages 24,000. Factory rent amount is 20,000. This will be recorded as factory expense. Factory power and fuel 18,000. Factory expenses. Factory electricity 21,000. Machinery 95,000. This will be recorded as an asset. To record in inner column because there is an adjustment of depreciation. Next is drawings 15,000. This will be deducted from capital of the proprietor on liability side. Next, office salaries 23,000. This will be recorded in profit and loss account on debit side. Office salaries 23,000. Cash at bank 5,000. This will be recorded as an asset. Cash at bank 5,000. Selling and distribution expenses 13,000. This will be recorded in profit and loss account debit side. Selling and distribution expenses 13,000. Bank charges 7,000. Profit and loss account debit. Bank charges 7,000. Discount allowed 5,000. Profit and loss account debit. Creditors 45,000. This will be recorded as a liability. There is adjustment on creditors, therefore recorded in inner column. Bad debts 2,000. Profit and loss account debit. Next, provision for bad debts 2,000. This is old provision. You can write to the credit of profit and loss account 2,000. Sundry debtors 49,000. There is an adjustment on debtors. Asset side you will be writing in inner column 49,000. Bills payable 46,000. Balance sheet liability side. Discount received 10,000. This will be recorded in profit and loss account on credit side. Sundry expenses 3,000. Profit and loss account debit. With this we have discussed all the items of trial balance. Let us start now discussion of adjustments. First adjustment is closing stock of raw material 16,000. This will have one effect. Manufacturing account debit, deduct from raw material consumed. Work in progress closing stock 10,000. This will be recorded in manufacturing account credit side. First item, closing stock of finished goods 28,000. This will be recorded in trading account credit side. We have given one effect of closing stock of raw material, work in progress and finished goods. All the items will be recorded as second effect in balance sheet on asset side. Closing stock of raw material 16,000, work in progress 10,000, finished goods 28,000. Second effect, this is a total closing stock is 54,000. Outstanding factory rent 1,000. This will have one effect as a liability on liability side, outstanding factory rent 1,000. Second effect it will have in manufacturing account under the heading factory expenses. We have to record outstanding factory rent 1,000. Depreciation on machinery 5% per annum. It will have one effect, deduct from machinery on asset side. The amount is 4,750. This will be recorded secondly in manufacturing account debit side. Depreciation on machinery 4,750. Depreciation on computer 20%. It will be deducted from computer on asset side. Depreciation at the rate of 20%. 6,400. Second effect, it will be recorded in profit and loss account to depreciation on computer 6,400. Now the most important adjustment, adjustment number 4. Debtors include 15,000 due from Amir. An amount of 8,000 is also due to him, which is included in creditors. So from debtors as well as from creditors, we have to deduct 8,000. From debtors we have deducted 8,000. It is 41,000. From creditors we have deducted 8,000. It is 37,000. Last adjustment. Provide reserve for doubtful debt 10% on debtors. This will be deducted from debtors and second effect will be in profit and loss account. Last adjustment, provide reserve for doubtful debts 10% on debtors. It will have one effect, profit and loss account debit, and second effect, balance sheet asset less from debtors. So we have debtors now 41,000 after deducting 8,000 of set off. On this 41,000, we have to calculate 10%, that is 4,100. This is the amount of new RDD. It will be recorded then in profit and loss account on debit side. New RDD 4,100. With this, we have completed all our adjustment of this sum. Now we'll be closing the sum and telling the balance. We'll be closing this problem. We have to first close manufacturing account. We have to consider this inside calculation And for example, raw material consumed, opening stock purchases, we have to add, closing stock we have to minus. We got the figure 334,000. Same in case of factory expenses, we have to add all the items 18,000, 21,000. Finally, that total is 64,750. Then we'll be taking total of debit side and we'll be deducting closing work in progress. Finally, we get balancing figure on credit side. This is cost of production or cost of manufacture. This figure is circled. This is a balancing figure. This amount will be transferred to trading account on debit side. In trading account on debit side, we have manufacturing account, cost of production transferred 418,750. Now we'll be closing trading account, total of credit minus total of debit. We got gross profit 89,250. This figure is circled. This amount of gross profit will be transferred to profit and loss account on credit side. In profit and loss account on credit side, gross profit is transferred. Now we have to close profit and loss account, total of credit minus total of debit. We got balancing figure on debit side. This is the amount of net profit. We have circled here 37,750. This net profit will be added to the proprietor's capital on liability side of balance sheet. In balance sheet, we have added net profit to the capital. Now closing capital is 1,27,750. Finally, we have to close balance sheet. Total of balance sheet is 2,11,750. Assets and liabilities both are same. That means problem is tally. It is correct. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKreeda. Subscribe to our channel eKreeda.